The intention of this piece was not to be exhibited in this glass case.
Never meant to be saved or celebrated, this particular piece was simply destined for some bulletin board, tacked up to inform the colonist of the actual declaration and its intent.
Like a flyer. Just like a flyer, like things that you see stapled to the telephone poles when you walk up and down Congress Street. I mean,
this Dunlop broadside original is one of some 200 actually printed on July 4, 1776 by John Dunlap. Virtually an exact copy of the ceremonial declaration piece, but minus all but two of the original 56 signers.
You can see from this particular piece, it's not signed by all the members. Only John Hancock and Charles Thompson, who was the secretary, have their names printed at the lower piece.
Now, this piece was donated to the Historical Society in 1906, but it wasn't until the 1990s that it was actually authenticated. And even though it has no real direct connection to the state of Maine, the folks here are still extremely proud to show it off. Even if it is only every 10 years or so.
Maine, especially with our relationship to Massachusetts and not being a state or one of the quote-unquote original 13 colonies, for us to have this a part of our collection is pretty significant.
Exactly where we'll probably never know, but 238 years ago, this very document most likely hung in the middle of some town square. The rest is a whole lot of American history.
Just being able to see this and see the methods of communication of the Declaration during the Revolution is an important thing for the 4th of July.
In Portland, Steve Minnick, WMTW News 8.